I was glad when it said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Welcome to Perfected Praise Worship Outreach Center at the Meadows. We are a church and community for the community. We are located at 31042 Smith's Ferry Road in Franklin, Virginia. Join us at 10:45 a.m. every Sunday for worship service, or join us here online for virtual worship. We love to have you in the midst.
Thank you. what you're doing in our lives right now, God. So have your way right now, God. God, for those who are watching via Facebook, Lord, God, touch them right now. Wherever they are, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Oh, God, meet every need in their lives, Lord, God. Speak to them.
Amen. 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 Am bask in the presence of the Lord, as we bask in the presence of the Lord, there is no other way. There is no other way. Hallelujah. One way, church, is I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man coming to the Father but by me. Come on, wife.
Mine.
Hallelujah. Y'all keep messing with me. Y'all keep messing with me.
Eight, nine, and then from 15 to 17. of the Old New King James Version, and it reads thusly. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. I'm going to read that again. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. Hallelujah. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in princes. Verse 15. The voice of rejoicing and salvation is in the tents of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord does violently, violently. I shall not die, but live, and declare the works of the Lord, the word of God, for the people of God. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you this morning. We thank you, God, for counting that robbery to visit us. Now, God, we ask that you will remain with us throughout the preaching and the teaching of this your word. God, I ask that you anoint the ears of the hearers,
yes,
those seated in my presence, those watching by way of social media. Meet the needs of your people today,
yes,
God. Anoint as only you can. Give life to this word, that it may be life for your people. And it is in Jesus' name that we pray. And the people of God say amen.
Amen.
And we sit in the presence
of the Lord.
Invite you to invite your family, your friends, your co-workers, your neighbors. Invite them and share in the word of God. I thank God for those who are in place and on post this morning. It takes a village. Amen.
Amen.
It takes a village.
Yes, it does.
Boast in his goodness.
Alright.
Boast in his goodness. God has promised us life and life more abundantly.
Mm-hmm.
The scripture suggests that God desires that we will live a life free from destruction, of lack in our lives, but rather have our very needs met. God has made promises in his word that we have access to an abundance and overflow more than enough as provisions are needed in our lives. If we will just be a people that will walk according to his word. We are reminded that the word tells us that we are willing and obedient. We will eat the good of the land. You will have plenty. And God will provide not only just plenty, but the best of everything. Trying to live. Church, we got to be vigilant. We got to stay focused. We cannot permit any distractions from the things of God. Because it's just the times in which we're living. We thought that we had the coronavirus beat. Those in high places thought as well. But we still have not lined up. According to the word of God. Line up on the line, precept upon the precept. And you know things will happen, and they will get our attention initially, and we'll laugh for a whole week. We may laugh for just a few days, but then we'll back up, and we'll go right back to our own way of living. I came back to let you know, God is not playing. God is not playing, church. We must be vigilant, focused, not permitting any distraction from the things of God, but rather exalted the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. People of God, we are members of a royal family, the family of God. We are a royal priesthood that is beyond nobody. We are people called out. We are set aside for God's purpose. We are somebody in Christ. Not only are we subject to His rules, the Word of God, we share in His Christian domain. We are heirs to the throne of God. God left us, and He decided the very best for every one of us. He said in His word, no good thing without the hope of those who walk upright. Come on, King Jesus. Those who live a life of integrity, doing what is right and pleasing God's sight. Those who are pursuing the kingdom of God. Not your own agenda, but you're chasing out God. You're chasing out His agenda.
Not only for what God has done, but for salvation.
salvation and being rescued from God's judgment. Because that's what happens when we submit our will to God's will and we submit our lives to Him. We don't have to stand in judgment. Amen? Hallelujah. He said, toss your sins into the sea of forgiveness. Never to allow it to rise and trouble you no more.
Yeah.
until God says it's over.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. It ain't over.
That's right.
Until God says it's over. To trust in the Lord than to put confidence
in man.
Anybody a witness?
Amen.
Is there anybody in the house that's a witness of God with me? Well, the real victor,
please
stand up. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. David knew something about mistrust.
My God.
David knew something about men that will make you think they think one thing of you and they're thinking another. When you look around, you're walking by yourself. It is not good to put confidence in man at all.
That's right.
David knew what it was like to have the divine hand of God operating and moving in his life. But many times David escaped defeat and death from the enemy's attack. But God, David's track record with God had taught him to trust God. Deception, opposition, conniving, scheming for his life from trusted associates, and even family members, and right down to his children. David knew what it meant to run for your life. Anybody run for your life this morning? Anybody run for your life? But I want to tell you this morning, keep on running, because you're going to end up running in the arms of Jesus. David learned in whom he could place his trust. He knew what it meant to have. He knew what it meant to have someone to forsake true companionship for fear of one's life. He loved Jonathan, but Jonathan's daddy hated him. My Lord, my Lord. People will hate you.
Yes, Lord.
For no apparent reason. But it's not you.
That's right.
But the God in you.
That's
it's not you, but it's the anointing on your life.
Jesus.
They see how resilient you are. They see when life comes and try to knock you down. Every time you bounce back up. Come on now. They don't realize that that's the Holy Ghost working on the inside. And that's with you from the outside. But God got the Holy Ghost on the inside working on you.
Yeah.
And the devil can't keep you down. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost will raise you up.
Yes, you will.
Hallelujah.
Reach it.
David had learned whom he could place his trust in.
Yes.
He learned upon whom he could depend. Church, you need to learn to depend on God. A man will fail you every time. Maybe God, he doesn't mean it, but he's in his flesh. And in his flesh, there's no good thing. And so the flesh will tell you what the Spirit is telling you not to do. Come on now.
Amen.
And we got to pray for the spirit of discernment.
Yes.
That's our navigation.
Yes.
That's our compass. Our spirit of discernment.
My.
And you need to ask God for it. Amen.
Yes.
So that you can be wise in the things of the Lord. Come on now.
Yes.
God would rather we be wise in the things of the spirit than the things of the world.
Yes.
Because if we hang out with folk in the world, guess what? You would end up just like
yes.
I don't care how spoiled you feel, how baptized you might be, or how long you say you've been saved. If you hang out with the wrong company, somehow, some way, I don't understand. But we become influenced.
That's right.
By the world. The devil has power, church.
Yes, he does.
But we're not insulting him this morning. Because God is all powerful.
Yes, he is.
Hello?
Yes.
So you gotta know whose camp you're playing in. Hallelujah. God is our refuge and our strength. David was expressing a person of light when he made that statement. I very present help in the time of trouble. David understood what it was like when all others walk away and forsake you. When he was in need of help, he had to depend upon God to come to his rescue. When he needed to be comforted, God showed up. When David needed protection for his life, God was there. Jehovah Shammah. And he is still Jehovah Shammah.
Yes,
all in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
He will come to your rescue.
Amen.
Don't call your BFF. Don't call your mama, your daddy, your sister, your brother. Call on Jesus. Because he can do what no other for him. David learned by demonstration that he could trust God to do what he promised he would do for his people. You ever had anybody make a promise and they didn't keep it? Somebody you thought you really could depend upon and they failed. Man will fail you.
Yes.
But God never fails. Hello, somebody.
Amen.
David learned that man would disappoint you. They would devise schemes against you, evil plots, and plans against you. Same as David had done.
Yes.
Karma is something. The seed you sow is the one you want in church. David learned that even the people attending church, even the people attending church with him, walk along the dusty road to the temple, have a conversation with him on the way.
Yeah.
Turned out to be some of his worst.
That's right. Enemies.
Just a little nugget. Spirit of discernment, church. Spirit of discernment. Everybody calling on Jesus and they're singing praise and calling on heaven. Tell me, you're not all not going.
Amen?
We understand why the Bible says there is nothing new under the sun. Sounds like a 21st century church to me. I don't know about you. But I'm so glad that God is still the same God, church. And God does not change.
Yeah.
God is still the same God that came to David's rescue. When his sons turned on him, when they tried to sabotage the throne from him, God stepped in on David's behalf. And God's still stepping in on behalf of his people. Hallelujah. He's the same God who saved David from the hands of Saul. He's the same God that forgave David for his act of disloyalty, lying, scheming, adultery. David was quick to repent.
My God.
David realized that he was not God.
That's right.
David realized that when he sinned, he didn't take on the same path. Oh, I ain't hurt nobody but myself. David realized that when he sinned, he sinned against God.
Yes, he did.
He hurt God.
Yes.
And David loved his relationship with Almighty God. But caught up in his sin, David was attacked, and David felt that God and his spirit had left him. And that's a terrible place to be in, church.
Yes.
That's a terrible place to be in. That you're so wrapped in who you think you are. You're so wrapped up in pursuing your agenda that you put God's agenda aside. And then you realize what a terrible mistake that you made. But God let you do what you wanted to do. He let you be as big and grown as you wanted to be. But when you come to your senses, when you come to your senses, church, and you start calling, undeserving favor.
Yes.
He loves us, church.
Yes.
In spite of our mess, God still loves us. And there is nothing that any of us, nothing that any of us have done,
that's right,
that God would not forgive us.
Yes.
He's a God that does not change. He's a God worth boasting about.
Yes.
He's a God worth proclaiming.
Yes.
Just don't blaspheme His Holy Spirit.
That's right.
And that's showing contempt, a lack of reverence for Almighty God. The only unpardonable sin. God is the same, church. Yesterday, today, and forevermore. and he is still El Shaddai.
Come on.
The all-sufficient God, the many-breasted God, that said that God is everything that we need, wrapped up in one. Should have been dead a long time ago. The car wreck should have killed you, but God protected you.
Yes.
My God, my God, my God.
Yes.
You were left for dead over your stunner, but God's angels were watching over you.
Yes.
And God made death.
Come on.
God made death behave. I am the God of Zion. God protected you, church.
Yes.
You out there being promiscuous. God will make your enemy your footstool, church.
Yes,
God took your full life of all the stuff that we had encountered, of all the things that we had done. And that was statement for man. Because the devil's ploy is to trap us,
yes, it is,
to deceive us, and to lure us. But that was the devil meant for man.
Yeah.
God turned around and meant it for your good. Won't he do it?
Yes.
Won't he do it?
Yes.
Psalm 20 verse 7 says, some trust in chariots and some in horses.
Well,
but we trust in the name of the Lord our God.
Yeah.
Another translation, some boast in chariots and some in horses. But we will trust in the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And if that wasn't enough, God gave us his only begotten Son. Years later, of what our lives would look like, how things would be for us, and how more difficult it would be for us to keep our hand in his hand. He sent along, but that didn't work. He sent prophets, men like us, to speak God's word, and that didn't work. But God loved us so much, too. He loved us so much that he did not and go to a devil's hell, because he created heaven for us.
Yes, he did.
And so he had a conversation with his son Jesus.
Yes.
They went to the boardroom, y'all, and had a conversation. And God said, I need a body.
Yes.
Not you are disobedient, and their hearts are far from me.
Yes.
I need a body.
Right.
I need somebody around that look like them.
Yes.
That talk like them.
That's right.
That walk like them.
Yes.
So they can see me in the flesh.
Yes.
Your life.
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah. And Jesus said, Father, hallelujah. Father, prepare me a body.
Yes.
And I'll go down, Father.
Yes.
That's the love of a son and a father. Hello, somebody. And I'll go down and redeem them.
Yes.
So they can come back to you. Aren't you glad?
Thank you,
and Jesus came.
Thank you, Lord.
He walked the earth as a little example. Boast in a God like that, who reached inside of himself and he pulled out his son, reached inside himself, young man, and he created a human being, put him in a virgin's womb.
Yes.
Could be tainted.
Come on now.
Could have been heaven touched.
Yes.
And made that young girl a mother.
Yes.
Mary, did you know
that
your baby boy?
Hallelujah!
Mary, did you know that your baby boy was coming to save the world?
That's right.
When you kiss his face, hallelujah!
Yeah.
You kiss the Savior, that's awesome.
Yeah.
That is awesome, church. But he did it for you, and he did it for me. And I'm so glad about it.
Yeah.
And that's why I can boast in the Lord.
Yeah.
That's why I can boast in his goodness. Because in spite of me, in spite of Pastor Hilda, God has been good to me. Haven't crossed every T and haven't dotted every I. But God's grace. God's grace has been with me. And I thank him today. And you ought to thank him today. Stand on your feet. You ought to praise him today. When you thank on the goodness of Jesus, what he's done for you, not for somebody else, but do the roll call on your own life. Count the cost. And see what God has done for you.
Yes.
What he's delivered you from. What he's covered you from.
Yes.
What he has kept hidden from others. Because he loved you just that much. And we come today to commemorate his death, his burial, and his resurrection. The Bible says, often as you do this,
so,
do it in remembrance of my death and my suffering until I return. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you for this word on today, God. Oh, God, we will put our trust in you. Many of us are walking around with hurts, brokenness, heavy loaded with a world of care. Because someone disappointed us. Someone hurt us. Someone that we had confidence in. broken. That's me. That is me. Would you remind us today to keep our trust in you, not to put our confidence in that.
Yes.
So God, we say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, God, for your word.
Church. He will
sin if you ask him. If you repent. And then he will send his Holy Spirit to find residence in you. And put you on a path off the street. If that's you, receive him today. If you're looking for a church home, you don't have to look in any further. Your home. We will love on you. We will support you. We will care for you. Is that you today? Is that you today? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can we give God a hand clap of praise, church? Can we give God a hand clap of praise? I just want to say something. That time is running out, church.
It is.
We need to get rid of that deception. That death is only for the old. And God is allowing it to be so that we recognize that we always obey that voice. And the world doesn't have a heaven nor a hell to offer you. But there are two places for you to go once you close your eyes to death. And that's heaven or hell. My Bible tells me that God said he did not prepare hell for his people. Not for his people. But the Bible also said that hell enlarges its borders daily. So that means that people are constantly dying and going to hell. We shared in the loss of a young lady last week. Everybody in the family is dismayed and in shock. She had suffered from an illness for her entire life, but it was something that went into the marriage and home. They would do what they need to do, and life would go on. Not this time. Not this time. Not this time. And just last week, she was with her friends. They had gone off together. Somebody had gone to the Bible to share time with each other. To share love. And just in a moment, in the twinkle of an eye, she was gone. Life is under paper, church. And it's now or never. We can't continue to put off. We cannot continue to put off what we think we have time to do. That young lady left children behind us. An 18-year-old and a 15-year-old. Mama devastated. Husband, children, friends. He has moved all of us. But it's an eye opener that tomorrow is not promised.
Amen.
She just had a birthday recently. She just turned 50. Holy Spirit will have me to share that. Holy Spirit would have me to share that. The funeral I attended last Sunday, young lady had been in the midst of a homegoing of another young lady. The preacher extended an invitation to those young people present and all assembled and asked if there were any of them that were not saved, would they receive Jesus as their Lord and Savior? And the young people's hands were raised. That young lady that died suddenly, and she left behind a 6-year-old, a 3-year-old, and a 1-year-old. But the pastor was informed that that young lady was in the midst, and she raised her hand. Hallelujah! Can we give God a hand of praise? She have to have been in the right place.
Yes, right.
At the right time.
Yes.
And her soul is with the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So that's what I'm saying to you, church. We don't have time. Yeah. But death knows no age. Death knows no age. So I invite you to receive Jesus today. have to stay on the straight and the narrow. Because it is what it is. So that's you today. And you're in need of a church home. Many times we think, I don't need that. But God is wise enough and smarter than we are to know exactly what we need. Receive that on today. Hallelujah. Can you give God a hand? I'm gonna praise this word. We invite you to meet us here again on next Sunday, same time, the same place. We thank you for the seeds that you have sown. Know that we have been water blessed because you have chosen to sow a seed into perfected praise, worship, our receptor. And I decree and I declare that you will receive a harvest. God gives seed to the sower. You want to God, I don't have enough. What do you know what you do have? But God, to the sword. Hallelujah. So we thank God for you. We ask that you will be encouraged. I pray that this word has blessed you today. And if it has, then respond in your giving. Father, we thank you for our Facebook family. We thank you, God, for all those who are suffering. We thank you, God, for what eyes have seen, ears have heard, and hearts have felt. We pray for our Facebook family, God, to keep them in your love and care until we meet again. And it is in Jesus' name that we pray. People, God, say amen. 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 Come on and give God a hand clap of praise.